Mr. President, yesterday the Chief Minister has given a specific response to the statement that you have made in Vadagara. Now, how are you going to counter those allegations made by the Chief Minister?
I have already made my stand very clear on the subject. I said the day of which this gentleman, Mr. Bhavan, has been appointed as the DG of Kerala, I had, in fact, expressed my views in categorical terms. While I was at Chennai the next day in the morning. Thereafter, for the last 2.5 years together, I've been continuing with that argument. I stick to what I said at Bhavan.
The timing of you really raising these allegations, very serious allegations, is kind of conspicuous because it's coming at a time when the state is reeling under an issue which you all as a party have been opposing. So with all of that really in mind, isn't it questionable the timing with which you've raised
it? Not at all. You are absolutely wrong. I made the statement immediately after appointment of Mr. Bhavan as Kerala DG. Immediately after the incident, next day itself, actually, Chennai is the place from where Mr. Vijayan comes, our Honorable Chief Minister. I made it my stand very clear over there. So don't say that it is the timing is very important. Don't say like that. I'm repeating that charge.
Why now?
Right?
Why now?
No, I'm repeating it. Doesn't mean that there was any break. 2.5 years elapsed since I started raising such a very important charge against Chief Minister.
In fact, Mr. Chief Minister has also said that Bhavan is one of the most well-qualified officers to be appointed as the state police chief at that time when the government came into power. And how do you counter that particular statement?
I just don't understand what is the speciality with an officer. Is he such an extraordinarily brilliant chap? What is his quality? He must explain to the people.
Do you think he is not that extraordinary?
I never say that he is extraordinary. Of course, the time when he was in the NIA, that term was 5 years term. Before that tenure was over, he has been changed. He has been asked to take continuous leave. Why? What is the reason? If he is a qualified person, a competent person, he should not have been asked to take leave. Explain to the people that circumstance under which he has been asked to take leave. Make it clear. Today, many of the important newspapers carry the story about that. His involvement in many of the cases, not me. I am not the person to reveal it because I cannot reveal that because oath of secrecy and office doesn't permit me to do so. That's the reason why I am not telling the truth in front of the press people.
So, what are your allegations? What are your allegations? What are your allegations? You've made some very strong statements, but what is the base? What is the allegation primarily?
Allegation, I told you that after having superseded 4 senior most DGPs in the state, who are one day other very qualified people, and the present DGP, Mr. Senkumar, is continuing in office. Your own Police Act says that he will continue in office for 2 years together. Before the tenure is over, what is the mad haste and what is the rush for you to change him from the position and supersede 4 senior DGPs of the state and appoint this gentleman? Tell us. The entire nation would like to know about that fact.
Do you think PMO has a role in this?
I wouldn't say it right now. When the right time comes, I will reveal more information about that.
CM has also asked you specifically one question. If you have found something really ridiculous or unacceptable in that particular file that you have mentioned, then CM is asking why didn't you...
First of all, you must understand that I did not make a mention of any particular file as a... Being the Minister of Home at that time, I said that I happened to see many of the sensitive files. I did not make a mention of any of the files like that. You just go through the statement made by me. Go through it. Hear it properly.
So, but the CM's question is...
This is CM's question, not my question.
CM's question, that is exactly what is absurd on his part. He knows nothing about what is happening in the Home Ministry and Home Department. He doesn't have any control. He proved to be a disaster in the Department of Home. That's exactly what is happening in the state for the last 2.5 years together. No control, nothing.
Sir, CM's particular...
Home affairs, it is a total mess.
Sir, CM's
Sir, CM's particular question to you was, if you found there was something wrong with the DGP right now, why didn't the UPA government act? Why was there no action against him?
Now, I told you that he has been kept away from his responsibility. He was not given responsibility. So that's it. There ends the matter. Okay.